Hi everyone, this is what I look like in case you just keep on hearing my voice everywhere. I wanted to give a quick overview of what we're going to be doing for the next number of videos. They're long videos, first of all, because I can't seem to shut myself up, but second of all, they are review videos for BIT1400. And as such, if you're feeling very, very comfortable with BIT1400, great. You don't need to watch the videos. If you did BIT1400 with anyone other than myself, I would still recommend watching the videos, just in case there's something you thought you knew, but you haven't covered a lot. For example, a lot of people I've been told in the past do not know pointers particularly well. Pointers are absolutely critical for everything we're doing the rest of the course. You may not remember structs very well. Definitely critical. We're not going to be hitting bit flags all that often, but we'll review when we need them. And then there's also an example of doing linked lists, which is important for later on in the term because we're going to keep on revisiting linked lists over and over again as an illustrative example of why we do polymorphism, why we do inheritance, what templating libraries look like. And so you're going to see these other, the linked lists stuff over and over again. I want to give one word of warning, however. One of my examples, and I'll let me double check what that example looks like. Sorry about doing this. Okay, it is min factor. I improvised an example finding the minimum factor of a number. That factorization of a number is if I take the number 15, it could be broken into multiples of prime factors. So 3 and 5 makes 15. 7 is a prime number, so its factorization is just 7, 1 and 7. So factorization is a very common mathematical thing. It's actually the foundation of why messages are safe on the internet. Factorizing is actually how you encrypt messages, or part of it is. It's actually a very hard problem to do in reality for really big numbers. But I did a little min factorization problem as one of the examples, and that is just finding the smallest factor of a number. So for 15, the answer would be 3. For 10, the answer would be 2. For 17, the answer would be 17. I have a bug in that code. So I wanted to get, that's the reason for this video. I wanted to get that out of the way before we got into the code itself. There is a bug in the code. And so rather than redoing the video, I thought, why don't we leave it out there and see if you notice what the bug is. There is definitely a bug. It snuck past me until I started coding and went, oh, there's the bug. So see if you can find that bug if you look at the slides, I've fixed the slides to make it work. But see if you can notice what the bug is that I've introduced and while I'm giving the example. So don't freak out if you go, well, there's clearly an error. I didn't notice the error right away. I fix it later on. And this is, I like pointing out when I am wrong, not because, you know, I make mistakes all the time or anything. Everyone makes some mistakes while coding. And it's not honest of us to show this perfectly immaculate code all the time and say, look, we don't have any problems whatsoever. It doesn't work like that. And so I want to show when mistakes are made. So we show also how we find what the mistakes are. And in this case, it was me tracing through the code, seeing how the algorithm works and going, oh, it's not going to work in this case. So see if you can notice that bug. But the reason this intro is just pointing out, if you are well-versed in C and C code, you may not even need to watch the videos, or you can just skim through what I'm talking about. If you want a review, I strongly recommend the reason I have this extensive review is because I've had enough students say that they don't remember any of this stuff when they did 1400. So take your time, do examples, code some stuff up, get a piece of paper out, doodle out some algorithms. I need you to get up to speed with 1400 before we go into 2400. It's going to build on itself. And after 2400, all your classes build on 2400. And so there's no sort of avoiding, or if it's not a one-to-one, 1400 and 2400 are not sort of isolated courses. They're not islands of knowledge. They are building on one another. And so if you don't remember 1400, you got to get up to speed before we start in 2400. And that's what these videos are for. All right. With that, I'm going to stop the video, and I hope you enjoy some of the review. Thanks.